So here are the two alum crystals that I made previously. This time I am trying to make a red alum crystal. If you don't know the steps of crystallization, here is the link of the detailed procedures. This time I used the two alum crystals to make a new crystal, so I have to prepare some smaller crystals. Put the big crystals into a plastic bag and use a hammer to make them into smaller pieces. Smaller crystals are better for crystallization process because it is easier for the alum to dissolve into the water. It is quite easy as alum is not very hard. Now choose a small piece of alum crystal as the seed crystal. I can do it like this because they are already pure alum crystal. If you don't know how to make when using the alum powder or impure alum, watch the video about crystallization to learn more. I tie the string around the seed crystal and tie the other end to a pin or any flat objects. It is quite tricky to do so. Just be patient. I can do it so fast because I make the clip faster. We will use it later and now we can just put it aside. Prepare a clean glass bottle or a jar and pour some amount of food coloring into the jar. I choose the red color since I think the final result will be a bit more special than the other colors. Pour a little amount of water to make it watery for mixing the coloring in alum solution easily. If the food coloring is in liquid state already, I think you don't need to add water. Same as the video that I made talking about crystallization. Boil a small amount of water and then put the alum powder or alum crystals into the water. I use a stirrer to dissolve the alum crystals in order to speed up the process. Just add more alum powder or crystals when they are completely dissolved. We are going to make a saturated solution. If alum crystals no longer dissolve, that means you have made a saturated solution. After you make a saturated alum solution, pour it into the glass jar containing the food coloring. Then place the seed crystal that we made previously into the jar. Don't let the seed crystal to touch the bottom of the jar. Place the seed crystal in the middle of the container is better. You can place a piece of paper on top of the jar and wait for several days. After several days, carefully take out the crystal and place it on a piece of filter paper or tissue towel paper. The paper can absorb the solution, make your crystal dry. Let me zoom closer a bit. I think the final result is pretty good. Now the alum crystal is colored thanks to the food coloring. Looking at the real crystal, I think it is in orange in color instead of red. Maybe next time I have to add more food coloring. You can try other colors. If you want to know the detailed procedures of crystallization and how to glow a big crystal, click the link and thank you for watching.